All right, so Josh, you're standing here right now with this little hairy recording character right now. What exactly are you doing here? You're pretty far from Gush Etzion.
Yeah, I came out here to the second annual Youth Sovereignty Conference to try to understand why these kids are a part of this organization, why they feel sovereignty is important, what this is all about, how these youth can actually make an impact when it comes to Israeli policy.
You think they really can at this point?
I don't know. Let's see what happens. I'd like to get a feel of who these kids are, where they're from, what they're all about, and what exactly they do.
Standing here in Bar-Ilan, what's the significance of us leaving Judea and Samaria to call for sovereignty in Bar-Ilan, in Tel Aviv?
I think that's even the most important thing that you can do. I mean, when I was the spokesperson for the Eshe Council, I actually lived in Jerusalem, and they said, what are you doing? You're not a quote-unquote settler. You live in Jerusalem, you don't even live in the settlements, I said, so-called. I said, that's exactly right. That's the point. The point is, if people in the so-called mainstream or in pre-1967 Israel are able to advocate for sovereignty over all of Judea and Samaria, we don't need to preach to the choir. It's all about getting everyone else on board in the country. That's why I think it's so important that something like this is happening in the greater Tel Aviv area, as opposed to just another parlor meeting in Gush Etzion or in Hebron or somewhere else where everyone already gets it. I think it's that much more significant that it's here in this area of the country. I mean, I spoke to Nadia just a few minutes ago, and she said it outright. She said that we picked this exact place, Bar-Ilan, because of the fact that the Prime Minister gave his speech back in 2007 here in this area. So she's doing it on purpose to reverse that policy statement by the Prime Minister. It's outright. It's out there. It's not something she's doing to be sarcastic or to be funny about it. She actually believes that that's the right thing to do. So she's saying it outright. She just said it to me a few minutes ago.
She's trying to go back to the Garden of Eden, saying, don't eat from the fruit. Don't eat.
Exactly.
Don't eat. Don't eat.
Exactly. I mean, listen, the two-state solution is dead, honestly. I mean, just look at the way the Israeli voting public votes. I mean, we went down the path of Oslo for 25 years, and what we got? We got over 1,600 dead Jews, okay? I think Israel has finally woken up and realized that we have to find another way. And the people here are advocating for sovereignty. So.